We're back. What is up, everybody? Yeah, look, Dookie's into his. So what the fuck is up with his camera right now? Jesus. All right, Dookie's back. He is worn. That's all he's done. Y'all saw that, like, Cal. Thanks for the gift, man. I appreciate that, my man. I appreciate that. Free games is good games, man. So yeah, it was Yo, PAX was crazy. It was fucking nuts, man. We'll go through the whole thing. I was happy to be there. Yo, what's up, Miss Laura? Like, Nora. Like, it was real fun to go to PAX. I'm happy to be home, though. Jesus Christ. Like, I will show you the monument. It's like a big, like the Washington Monument, but smaller. Yo, I'll tell you the story with that guy. My legs, I still can't walk right because I am so sore from that goddamn. I thought I was going to die. I thought that I don't want to give it all away, but I'll show you the pictures of it. It's pretty cool, man. So, like, Friday we did PAX, or Thursday night I got in. We hung out with, I met GT Red Wolf and Guns Before Roses. Who else did I meet? And then, she got into this contest, like the big Omegathon, or whatever they call it. Like, the people who actually throw the event have this big thing. You look real happy. I'm happy to be home. It was fun. I had a lot of fun, man. Like, you all have got to go to a PAX or something. That was crazy. Like, when you see the pictures and see how big this place was, how much shit was around there, like, you could definitely do it all. Like, if I go again next year, which I don't know, we got a man down, clean up an aisle too, man. If we go next year, I think I'm only going to go Friday and Saturday and come home on Sunday. I think you can do most of it in 2 days. The only thing I missed on Sunday was a panel. Like, one of my favorite streamers, Cobalt Streak, was on there. But I was like, I said, you know what? I'm just going to take the day and see Boston, which you'll see a ton of pictures. I put more, you're wearing a white t-shirt, Vince. Well, that's kind of, it's like tan. It's supposed to be like desert tan or something, man. You better got some action. Yo, can't talk about those things, Deputy. We can't talk about those things. He's been waiting for days. I know he has. All he wanted to do was kill himself in my chat. It's all he fucking cares about. He just wanted to die, and that's it. Let's see. So Friday morning, we go to PAX. And, like, I'll show you pictures of the convention center. It's fucking humongous. And it doesn't look as big on the outside. When you walk and stand on that motherfucker for, like, 6 hours, yo, you were tired. Like after day one, my back, my legs. I mean, I got back to the hotel out for like an hour, man. It was crazy, man. That means at least a three-way. We're not going to talk about what happened. But I met, like, that guy, Jan Viper, part of our controller, Geek Stream team. Met him, his fiance, that Jay Halibut 67, who's in the chat all the time. Yo, I met and shook Bacon Donut's hand. Believe it or not, I met that guy. He was really cool. I didn't have much time to talk to him. I really didn't meet a lot of streamers. I saw a lot of them, like Giant Waffle, his girlfriend Savitia Union, or whatever her name is. I was right next to Lyric. Y'all, I literally rubbed up on a Summit 1G. That little Summit 1G is freaking small, man. He is, like, really short. He's cool, though. Who else did I see up there? Sevidus I saw, Wolf 21 I saw Thethy from Thethelia Craft. I saw her there. I saw, I saw Dead Pine. I know there's gotta be a ton of streamers I saw. I have no idea what the fuck their names are, though, because they're like, you could tell, like, if you go to the, I'll show you the Twitch booth in a little bit, but you get to the Twitch booth and they're all, like, hanging out in the back. Oh, Co Carnage was there. I recognized him. A guy named Lag TV, Maximus Black. I used to watch him all the time back in the day when I first started watching Twitch. He's really talented, man. He can sing really good, too. Watched him a lot. I saw him. Aurelian was there. Future Man. I saw Future Man. There's just a shit ton of people, man. Just one after the other. And there's so many of them there. Like, you don't even know who the hell they are. You want picture time? Are we going to start with picture time? Let me see if I got this set up right. All right, this is picture time. Hold on a second. All right, so basically, this is the first picture, okay? This is, like, literally coming off of the street in Boston. So this is, like, as soon as you come out of the back bay... Boston. This is the exit of the actual train station. And then we got together with GT Red Wolf and his girl Guns Before Roses, met me at the train station, and we mingled around for a little bit, and then we went to this mall, we got something to eat at this pizza joint, and the dude at the pizza joint was like, he actually knew what Twitch was. Like, the guy who waited on us, he took cards and everything. He was pretty cool, man. He's like, I was surprised someone, there's not many people you walk up to and you talk to every day even know what the fuck Twitch is. Let me take this off. Alright, anyway, so when we were done, man, because you can't read, there you go, them Isaac Pertz, yeah, I got him off of there, so we went to the Cheesecake Factory. Yo, I'm telling you right now, $8 for a motherfucking slice of, tiny ass cheesecake. God damn, it was good. I ate the Cheesecake Factory 3 motherfucking times up there, I ain't lying. Cheesecake was on point. This one, a particular one, I had the Snickers cheesecake, which was in the house. That was good. So we sat by this fountain right here, right? And so I'm looking in the background at this picture. I'm like, yeah, that's a motherfucking church. I said, that's got to be a church. I said, you know what? I'll tell you, we didn't go over there. We just, basically where you see the picture was taken is where we were standing. We were, I said, man, I bet that's one of them Scientology churches. This is no lie. That church back here is a Scientology church. So yesterday, when I went back yesterday, I made sure I came back just to this church, and I actually took pictures of it, because this is like a freaking big, expensive freaking church. It's ridiculous. All right, here's this is the Boston Convention Center. So it's like, as you're coming out of the train station, this is what you see, and you see the big overhang here. So basically, you probably, let me see. All right, so basically, there's a street in front of here, okay? This is Friday morning. Yo, what's that, Capizan? Yeah, he's alive, man. This is Friday morning at about 9:45. I overslept the first day. I didn't get down there till almost 10. So basically, yo, on Friday morning, if you didn't get there at about 7 a.m., it took me 1 hour and 45 minutes to get from the curb into inside the building. 1 hour and 45 fucking minutes of standing and barely moving 3 inches at a time. Yo, what's up, Miss Dear Lord? I did, girl. How are you doing? It was really cool. It's picture time right now. Picture time. So this is where PAX East was, the Boston Convention Center. This is like a walkway leading up to it. This is downtown Boston. Like, basically, if I'm standing here to the straight looking at this, this is what was on my right-hand side. This is all downtown Boston. This is more of downtown Boston. There's the side of the convention center over there. All right, and then when you walk, this is a bad picture for some reason. When you walk in, this is the inside at the very top of the steps. So as you're coming into PAX East, this is what you see. It was just flooded with fucking people. That's a blurry picture for some reason. All right, this is a picture for Aimless. You guys know Aimless. She's a creative streamer on Twitch, which she comes to my channel sometimes. We go to her sometimes. She created this design called BrainBot. BrainBot is a bot that's used. We're going to probably switch over to BrainBot. There's a lot of really cool shit BrainBot does. It costs money per month to run it, but it's like the stuff they were showing me, man, it was really, really, really cool. Plus, the mods can take a lot more control of it, and I like it. I liked it, man. The guy, checked it all out. Nice shirt. You like that? Keep it. I bought this shirt just for PAX. Keep it classic. So that was BrainBot. That was just a bot that was there. This is the Twitch Town Hall. You know, at 4 o'clock on Friday, the Twitch Town Hall, which is broadcast live on Twitch. So I was part of that, and this is where they do the same thing every single year. Twitch Town Hall, PAX East, they're kind of blurry. They're going through the channel feed section, and they had 3 different examples. One was like It Me JP, one was somebody, other big streamer, and the third example about channel feed betas was Slend, our buddy Slend, who's actually mentioned in the town hall meeting for all of Twitch and everything to see. All the millions of broadcasters, they picked his from March 31st to show at Twitch Town Hall. So I took a picture of it and tweeted out. I thought that was pretty cool. These are just more. I took a lot of random shots of just like Boston. This is a shot. This is somewhere near the convention center too. Looking at this is going towards downtown Boston. This actually, I think this is going to Fenway Park. All right, yeah, this is Fenway Park. So on Friday, let's see. Love the old, yo, wait, Hollywood. Wait till you see fucking downtown. The pictures I took downtown. It was crazy. Boston is awesome. Like, I thought it was going to be some shit-ass hole in the wall, like, town, you know, like New York City. Like, man, I mean, New York City is nice, too, but, man, yo, Boston was awesome. So then I was like, on Friday, I wanted to walk down to Fenway Park to take pictures of the baseball stadium of Fenway Park. Because, you know, there's fucking history there. It's a really, really cool place to go. You know, it was built in 1912. It's the oldest ballpark in the world, basically, in the United States for Major League Baseball. But, like, as you look onto that field, every single baseball player from 1912, Hall of Famers, Babe Ruth, all of them have all played in that stadium on the same exact field you were looking at. I thought that was really cool. So I walked down there on Friday. I got there, like, probably about 9 o'clock. So this is the outside as you walk up to it. You know, that's the scoreboard back here. This is the green wall on this side. I didn't realize you could take a tour of the place. So, because I walked up to a guy and asked a couple of questions to some dude. This is just the outside of them walking up to it. This is like one of the side streets. That right here, this part of it over here is the green monster. If you know what I'm talking about, the big, you know, the big 37-foot, 2-inch green wall. That's actually right there on that side. This is third baseline, Coca-Cola sign. It's just really cool. This is the very front of the... of Fenway Park. Would love to see it. Oh, yo, I got in on Thursday. Did you get any pictures for your deputy? We ain't gonna talk about what happened at late nights, man. Anyways, Fenway Park. This is the very front of it. So this is what you would have seen in 1912, apparently. This is how old it is. Pretty cool. This is the very front. All their World Series and National League Championship. American League Championship. Whatever league it is, I don't know. I'm not too good at baseball. I like watching it, but I don't know all that shit about it. That's the front of the building. I mean, this is the actual side street. That's the plaque saying it was built in 1912, whatever. This is when you go inside, you take a tour for like $18. I think you take a tour. It's about an hour long tour. So you go inside, you know, there was like a real old guy doing it, but man, he was really good. He knew everything about it. So this is like, as soon as you walk in, this is what you see. Back here is some kind of Range Rover, and there's a couple Lexuses over here. They've got to be either like executive cars or player cars. You know what? It had to be executive. The players, I got here on Thursday night. There was a game on Thursday night, and on Friday they left. Because I'm going to tell you right now, if there was a game going on Friday night or Saturday night, yo, my ass would have been there. Because I should have stopped the day. I should have gone to Boston a day earlier and hit the baseball. So this is the inside of the stadium. This is right behind home plate. That's the green monster right there. Scoreboard, third, but you know, this is just the inside of the park, which is really cool. You know, you can stop and take a bunch of pictures. This year they added all this netting behind here to protect everybody because of foul balls and all that good stuff. This is the look down the first baseline. These are all the people down here that took the tour with us. I took a ton of shots, man, of this. This is something about, remember the Jimmy Fund? No idea what the hell that is. This is like a really, really old-ass Boston painted sign of it. It seems kind of small. It's probably small because it's so old. Because it's definitely old. This is all the championships and the pennants they've won. This is as if you're standing up on top of the green monster looking down into Fenway Park. So this is the point where you're like, you're on top of that wall, the seats right there. Yo, if you go to Fenway, you got to get a green monster, get one of these seats. There's only like maybe like 50 of them, but yo, this is the best shot of the park. So you can kind of like look in and see everything. It was pretty cool. I took a couple shots from up here. This was my favorite part of the whole fucking Boston, man. It was crazy. There's your, you know, it's so weird how the infield of this stadium, they go through the history of why it's the infield is the way it is, and the whole yards, man, it's crazy. And basically they've been at, like, these Cumberland deck, I think the Cumberland deck or the Budweiser, I don't remember, somewhere over here, these seats are new for this year, like, every year, and these are the skyboxes, every year they keep adding seats and stuff like that. They got to make money. What's up, Kev? How you doing, man? This is again looking at the green monster. This is kind of like the view of, like, you can see downtown Boston straight from the stadium. It's really fucking awesome. This is like, they didn't have like a memorial, like a whole museum. That is actually Babe Ruth's, like the fucking Babe Ruth baseball bat that he used in Fenway Park at one point or another. That's just really cool, man. Really cool. They had all kinds of cool shit. They had the statues outside, the big bronze statues outside, the teammates there. Then you got Carl Yastrzemski, whatever the fuck his name was. I can't remember pronounce his last name. He's there. And that's, of course, Ted Williams. That's the newest one they put up. And then I got a selfie. See, there's my selfie with Ted. It's me and Ted. Because we're boys. Ted and I are boys. I am beat, man. I am wore out. So I find, and then somebody took a picture of me with the teammates right there. That's pretty cool, man. Pretty damn cool. Calm your lady boner down. Calm your lady boner down. Let's see. And then this is the outside backside of the stadium. That's the scoreboard, the back of the scoreboard. Not smiling. I don't fucking smile. I'm just, you know, I wasn't big other one happy. All right, now these are all Friday. I couldn't take any pictures of PAX East because my phone, I forgot. I brought my damn battery pack. I forgot the cord for the charger. So I couldn't take any pictures. So Saturday, I spent a ton of time taking a lot of pictures. This is the ARK survival booth. You know the game ARK? And they had a tournament going on there Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And you had to wait in this fucking line that was over 2 hours long. And the lines at PAX, what they do is they set a maximum. And once that last person gets in line, no one else is allowed to line up behind that person. So you had to constantly keep coming back. And yo, I was not going to wait to get on top of this motherfucking... You could climb to the top of... You can actually see the stairs right back here. You can get on top of this freaking T-Rex and get your picture taken, man. I thought that was pretty awesome, man. Rednecks don't know how to smile. Exactly. It's not cool to smile. Exactly. So a lot of people were literally just lined up for 2 hours to get on top of this dinosaur to get a goddamn picture of you on this dinosaur. What's up, Mr. Shane Nobody? Thank you very much. Did I win a dinosaur? Hell no. I don't think I won anything. There's tons of free fucking... I got video. I got codes to games and stuff like that. So that's the ARK survival booth. There was a big Doom booth that was there because that game's about to come out. It was a real big deal. A lot of shit going on. This was right next... Doom was right next to the Twitch booth. There's a better shot of it there. That's the actual Doom booth. I mean, it got like fucking... You want that dino? Yeah, you had to get a crane to put it somewhere, Nora. That thing probably weighs a ton. This is the Twitch booth at PAX. So as soon as you come into PAX, you go down to the exposition pit or hall or whatever it is. You go down the steps and to the right. This is right where Twitch was. They're right at the very front. And Doom would have been to the right of this. Bethesda, all the Bethesda games are right to the left of this. And up there, I think that's Bacon Donut was up there. And I'm not sure who that guy is. That might be Tally. Is that Tally? And that's Bacon Donut, I think. Those are the two that are there right there. Yeah, I saw him. Yeah, I saw you won the custom GT or a custom PS4. It's pretty awesome, man. Pretty awesome. I didn't know any of that stuff was going on. I didn't sign up for no raffles, nothing of that stuff. And then back behind this wall was where the Twitch Partner Lounge was. That's where all the partners hung out, and there's like a small little walkway. You can get in a line, and you can meet some of them, all that good. I didn't do any of that shit, though. I was, like, too busy walking around. And this guy up here, he's, like, the main guy at Twitch. He was there, like, doing all the presentations and all that good stuff. This is Battleborn. This is the whole area of the Battleborn. This is, like, the big fucking display they had of Battleborn. I have no idea what the hell Battleborn was. Don't even... And I'm not interested in it, but that place was packed. The PlayStation had a big PlayStation booth. They had Ratchet and Clank. They had Uncharted 4 was there. Killing Floor 2. All the fucking games. NFL, whatever. Just, they had like probably 30 PS4s with TVs going crazy there. They also had the whole setup for the VR. I didn't do any VR because that shit... Like, I talked to two people that did it, and the two people that I knew had motion sickness, but nowhere near as bad as me. They said within 5 seconds they were getting sick, so I didn't even fuck with no VR. Not to mention VR lines were pretty long, pretty damn long. World of Warships was there. This is actually as soon as you come down, right as soon as you come down the steps to the left was Wargaming.net. This is World of Warships, World of Tanks. JB would have had a blast over here, JB Warsmith. And there was another game, Wargaming.net, I think. But those were some pretty cool games. Here's the World of Warships right here. You can actually get back there and play and all that good stuff. I took this picture for Night Owls, Miss Night Owls. It'll protect me from all the evil in the world, maybe. Maybe. It's the Ratchet and Clank one. Gears of War 4 had a big tournament there. That was another big thing. That was actually Gears of War 4... was hosted by CDN the Third. I never got to see that guy. I really wish I had met him.
seas.
He's an awesome man. You want to pee so badly. There's not many more pictures of PAX left, actually. There's a lot of Boston pictures, though. Was Isaac there? Yo, Big Willie? No. But there was one booth that was doing... They were selling RAM for your PC, and they were playing Isaac. You could play Isaac there. This is a Square Enix booth. They had Final Fantasy XIV, Star Ocean, Kingdom Hearts, Road Rally, or the Rally Evo, Hitman. Hitman had a virtual reality Hitman thing. I'm not sure what it was, whatever it was. I really didn't check it out. I just saw people playing it. I think it was called Hitman VR, though. Imagine that. But they had a big thing. If you could go in there and beat like Sephiroth in Final Fantasy 14 with a group of eight people, like random eight people just go out there, you won t-shirts, shit like that. It gave away so much shit at this place. Overwatch was a humongous thing. They had a big ass booth there. Overwatch was one of the biggest things there. I took a few pictures of that, and everybody, that place was nonstop, packed, line, everything. You can, all these games you see, everyone can play. You just got to sit in line, work your way up to the front, and eventually get to play them. And I was not sitting in line to play no games that I really didn't want to. I played all the indie games. Like the indie games, you could walk up to them and play them. I found some really fucking great indie games, too. This is some kind of Pokemon thing. I don't know what the fuck it was. Oh, no. This is Monster Hunter Generations. I didn't spend too much time on that. But they had a big-ass, like, blimp thing in there, which is pretty cool. This is going across, there's like a sky bridge going across the old convention center. And this is as you're looking, this will be the front, this over here. Wait a minute. I'm trying to think which direction to what. I don't remember now. I think this is the front of the convention hall. So Outlast 2 was there. No, Outlast was a ridiculous line. Like, it was crazy, man. You got a half full bottle of beer nearby. Yo, there you go. Blizzard, no. I didn't see any World of Warcraft. It was all Overwatch, really. All Overwatch. Geico sponsored all the Hearthstone. So right here where the Geico sign is, that was the big Hearthstone tournament going on all weekend. Over here, right above the Geico, this whole area, like all this, where at AMD, all this stuff right here, this is all the indie games. This was where I spent most of my time in here. Looks like a great game. I'm not gonna play it. I don't play first person shooters. I mean, it's not my thing. All this is actually indie games too. No. This is the arena for League of Legends. We'll see that in a minute. Outlast 2 was a really big thing there too. Here's the League of Legends had a big ass tournament going on there every fucking day. This is where all the hooting and hollering and nonsense was going on with the professional sports broadcasters and all that shit. So this area right here was busy all weekend long with the biggest professional teams, I guess, in the world were up here playing against each other. I spent about, 3 seconds in there, and that was about it. What was phenomenal about PAX East, which I had no idea, was the tabletop gaming that is there. So this is like the back third of the convention center, right? I'm still on this sky bridge. So you can see all these tables are just full of Magic the Gathering, D&D, card games, board games, strategy games. You fucking name it, it is back here. And it was just like, they had a these table with like 50, probably, no, not 50, probably like more like 300 board games. You can just leave your picture ID, pick up a war game, get your buddies, randomly pick people from the crowd, doesn't matter. Just people were like going crazy playing with one another. It's pretty cool. Yo, what's up, Miss Not Owls? Don't get stuck in the box. I hope you can't stick your ding-dong in that bottle. I hope it's got one of them wide mouth bottles. This is the tabletop gaming. So this is where all, there was so much shit you could buy there. These are bad photos, but this is more of the tabletop. Tabletop went one side to the other, and this is a really bad picture, but this up here is actually the Discord, where the Discord partners and the Discord booth was back here. This is where I saw Lyric. Lyric was doing a meet and greet at Discord, so I saw him. I never went out there to meet him. The line was kind of long to go meet Lyric, believe me. But I only saw Lyric that one time. I didn't see him anywhere else. And this Vive right here, this is all the Steam virtual reality headsets. All this over here was another, like some kind of PC tournament they're having going on. Alright, girl, this is some of the cosplay you would see. I don't know, this guy is from like I don't know. Is this guy from like Dark Souls or something? I have no idea who the fuck this guy is. The cosplay here was unreal. The people who put the time, money, and effort into building their costumes to do their thing was quite impressive. Definitely quite impressive. No idea what the hell. This is like a VR. This guy is sitting like on an exercise bike, right? He's got the VR thing on. Here's the sensors for it over here and over here. And he's actually on this like, he's on a like a exercise bike, like riding through the mountains and shit. It was ridiculous. Were they doing anything with Microsoft HoloLens? I didn't see any of that. I never went to the Xbox stuff, but I didn't see any of that. I thought, not sure what some of those are. This was one of the really cool, Mecha Zoo is coming out, or is it already out on PlayStation? I don't remember. This is one of the really cool indie titles coming out. I'm really interested. I talked to that guy for a long time, so he's got my information. I got his, we'll see. That was a really cool game, Mecha. I took this picture for fucking Hollywood. Yo, Hollywood, this picture's for you. Because I know you play a venture capitalist. Yo, the mobile part, they had a whole section full of iPad, Android games just for those. Ridiculous, man. All right, see you later, Mr. Shane. Thanks for the host, man. Appreciate it. Appreciate that. So, like, I never knew, like, the mobile platforming was a really big thing, but it seems like it's getting pretty big. This is another cosplay girl I saw. I think I only took two pictures. This is the second one. I have no idea who this girl is, but I did go by that big-ass dinosaur arc, and that bitch was sitting on top of the dinosaur with a big club at one point, but she got down before I could take a picture. It's pretty cool. Who the hell is this girl? Does anybody know who this girl is? I have no idea who this girl is. Does anybody have an idea? Let's see. Uncharted 4. This is the PlayStation 1, Uncharted 4. This is the Star Fox was really cool. They had this, like, thing, like almost like a little spaceship you would sit in, you would grab the controller and you look like you were flying the spaceship. It's pretty cool. All right, now we're gonna get to all the downtown Boston stuff. That was all the PAX East. Yo, I took a picture for you, Night Owls. Where is it? There it is. Fuck, get the hell out of this. How'd I get out? Uh-oh. Alright, where was that picture at? This is the picture I took for Hollywood. God damn it. Where'd it go? Why did I just leave that? Hold on. I just lost it. Pandora monthly ads, pictures, dashboard. That's weird, I deleted it. Screen capture, hold on. Then this is it right here. Hold on. I don't want to keep the aspect ratio. All right, let's move that down. There's back. There's your Ratchet and Clank girl. There's Ratchet and Clank. That was the picture I took for you. All right, let's get back to this. All right, now let's see. Now let's go to Boston. Sleepy Mocha Miss Vega. What? Her name is Future Vincent Vega. Who's that? Who are you talking about? Anyways. All right. So this is downtown Boston. This is a lot of pictures. I just randomly was walking down the streets taking pictures of Boston. So this is like all downtown area. I thought it was really cool how like all the old, there's a shit ton of old buildings with new buildings all involved. These are like bad photos though because my camera is kind of fucked up on my phone. This is the, I don't know. That was one of the coolest buildings. It's got a big clock on here in all four sides. Hoping it's the addict. No, you don't see any of that. These are just side views of all the street corners, which Boston is really compact, man. It was really cool. This is the oldest. I can't remember that. They read the Declaration. After the Declaration of Independence was read in Philadelphia, 2 weeks later they brought it to Boston. This is the building where it was read from. This is where the Boston Massacre happened, was right here. It's the old courthouse or whatever the hell they call it, but it's like from 17 or 1680 something. It's fucking old as hell. I didn't even realize I caught that in the picture, man. It's ridiculous. And this is just another random side street. This is as you're walking from like the subway station stop all the way down to the waterfront. And this is another, I thought these cool, I love these cool, these side street man looks are pretty awesome. History, yep. And then this is another side street. I just love all the pictures, man, of the big cities. Big city. This is actually part of the big dig. Like before they, underneath of all this square right here, where this walkway and the streets here, under that is the interstate, you know, buried under it. But that was all part of the big dig. This is all part of it right here. All this was the big dig, same thing. I thought, I like this building up here. I have no idea what it was. Probably somebody's house, you know, apartment complex. This is just more and more pictures. This is my selfie with the penguin at the aquarium. Selfies with a penguin. Yes, right there. So then I went to the National Aquarium yesterday. These are all just pictures from there. And they got like four or five different kind of penguins. They're all just hanging out. These things are fucking noisy as hell. Like, penguins aren't that great. They're like really, really noisy. That's a sea lion or sea whatever. Some kind of like, you know, sea thing. Sea lion. I think it's called a sea lion, something like that. These are just random fish pictures. You know, they had all kinds of cool shit at this, National Aquarium. I took a ton of pictures here. It's some kind of tropical reef somewhere in the goddamn world. I'm not sure where it was at. This is really weird. I forgot the name of this fish, but this fish is fucking weird, man. I have no idea. Look, it's got like a little horn or something coming out the top of his head. I don't know what kind of fish that was. There's a sheep's head. Let's see. There's a big, this, that fish right there. I couldn't get the whole picture of him. That motherfucker was huge. That's like a little underwater cave over there. This is the sea turtle. Yo, this sea turtle was like probably from the tip of his nose to his ass. It was probably 5 foot long. The thing was freaking humongous, man. Absolutely humongous. So it's just random more fish pictures. I took a ton of pictures of the sea turtle because he was badass, man. He was freaking huge. Alright, sea turtle, where you at? I got one blurry one. There it was. Din, din, din. There was like tuna in here. It's tiny penis. It could be a penis on its forehead. You never know. I have no idea. It was standing erect, so it might have been horny. I'm not sure. There's that big ass turtle. There was like, I think there's two turtles in there. One was sitting at the bottom, and that guy up there was like hanging. It was almost feeding time for the turtles. That bitch was huge, man. I got a turtle fetish, as you can tell. Called a Vince fish because it's horny. Maybe not. We should call it the V-squared fish, right? That's a big-ass lobster. Look at the claws on this motherfucker. That bitch was humongous. Like, I've never seen a lobster. This is like a ghost fish or something. He was kind of weird and creepy. Freaking humongous. That's an electric eel. That motherfucker was shock your ass. Like, they had a voltage meter in there, man. If you stuck your finger in there, you're going to get shocked. You are going to get... It was like... It was nuts. Y'all took a lot of pictures. It was cool. These are the seahorses. You can see the seahorses back here. I took a bunch of pictures of the seahorses because they would not sit still. These bitches were flying all over the place. They wouldn't sit still. There's a good picture of seahorses there. There's like little ones. There were like real small ones and like some bigger ones in there too. That's the poisonous frog somewhere in the goddamn Amazonian's jungles over there. All right, more frogs. There's like a frog there, frog in there. It is actually like another one. There's a ton of frogs in this one photo. I couldn't find them all though. This is like some kind of mangrove thing or something, poison dart. Yes, what they were. There's like four different kinds. They were really cool looking though. You touch and okay. This is a sea dragon. I've never heard or seen a sea dragon before. Vega turns every straight man gay. It's my beard, Nora. It's my beard. There's a bunch of sea dragons back here. I don't even know where in the ocean they live, if you can eat them. I don't know. I want to fish that I can eat. These are freshwater polka dotted stingrays. They were really cool. I think that was a grouper. I can't remember. There's the sea lion again. I actually took this picture for the cleavage shot back there. But, you know, there's the sea lion right there, too. It's all good. These are the sea nettles, the man-o-wars, or whatever you want to call them. They were pretty wicked. These were really cool looking, man. You know, you get stung by them. Watch it! Watch it. So this is downtown. This is the harbor, downtown Boston area, right next to the aquarium. Aquarium's over here on the left. That over there is Logan International Airport. The airport's back there. Let's have a look over here. That's that same building, but a better view. That's the actual aquarium itself where I hung out. Jellies. Mm-hmm. And there's my Skittle. There's me waiting for the bus. You know, my Skittles pose. Hey, look at that. That's funny. People, no people. People, no people. That's weird looking. This is the USS Constitution, the oldest naval, the first big warship the United States ever built. It's got a lot of history, man. The guy inside of this place was phenomenal about all the shit he knew about it. But right now it's in dry dock. They're taking all the copper off the bottom, putting new copper on it. So I went inside of here. You can go inside. This is like the captain's quarters where the officers would eat at. That's the actual captain's bed back there in the whole nine yards. This is the captain quarters. That's where you steer the ship from the bottom. That would be like the first mate deck, I think, or something like that. This is the inside of it again. That's where you steer the main shaft of the boat. It's nuts. Yo, what's up, Mooley? You were stunned by a Portuguese man of war? Oh, my God. I bet that felt great. I've been on the U.S. Constellation. That's in Baltimore, Maryland. That's what I'm familiar with. This is the sister ship. This is the one that was built first. Constellation survived, too. I guess that's sort of the stuff they introduced later with, like, steam power, or I'm not sure what that is. This is the fucking one of the cannons. It was just sitting on the side of the deck. They took all the stuff off. And that's the actual just sitting out the entrance. That thing is freaking humongous, man. It's the exactly the main shaft. Yes. Yes. And this is a replica of somebody did the boat model building. This is another replica of somebody did a boat building. That is ridiculous. Like, I don't know how long. They actually had like a club that works inside this museum making replicas of old boats. It was pretty cool. You nearly drown, which them bitches will kill you. These are like ceremonial sword, pistol, like they would present the captain if they won a battle, whatever. These are all actual gold-plated, the real deal. Really nice stuff. All right, look. My Boston trip was great till I decided I could conquer the fucking steeple, the tower. All right, that right there is Bunker Hill. That is Bunker Hill, like where the Battle of Bunker Hill took place. This is Bunker Hill National Monument. You can climb to the top of this cocksucker. I highly recommend you don't do it. Don't do it. I'm telling you right now, don't do it. That's like the big bridge from the dig in Boston. That's a big popular place too. This is Charlestown, Boston. This is the park, and this I'm not sure who they are, but I thought this was a really good photo. Not this one, but that one is right next to Bunker Hill. Take the hill. So like, it's a giant penis. It doesn't have a round. That's got like a triangular picky point. You know what I'm saying? But yeah. So that was the. So for free, you can go inside the museum and you can go ahead and get a ticket. And you can walk up this cocksucker. They're like, oh, it's 294 steps. I got thinking to myself, yeah, it's no big deal. It's a square building. It should wrap around the outside in a square type oval, no problem, right? I'll show you what the fucking steps look like. So you walk up here, and there it is right there. That's William Prescott. He was the guy that was there, 1776. That's right outside of it. That's the Bunker Hill Monument. You can see all of Boston. This is the iron doors leading inside of it. Inside, it's built out of stone. And the inside has a round shaft. It goes all the way to the top. So when you get to the top, you look through the grate and you see all the way down to the bottom. And this is like just a replica of it in the bottom of it. These are the steps. They're about 3 feet wide, right? Walk up this cocksucker. It's crazy, dude. So you can see how they're labeled. That's step 10. Step 10, and it goes around the whole, you know, it's just a big a giant circle. Okay, so the story goes like this. Wait, let's get a picture of this thing. Wait, okay, so when I first saw this thing, I'm like, you know what, no big deal. The, you know, you can go up this thing, the stairs should like go up alongside of the outside of the building, no problem. We'll walk all the way to the top, take a look, no big deal, and come back down, right? Yo, man. Yo, I started going up this cylindrical thing right here. I started going through this right here. I got to about 75 to 100. I started thinking to myself, you know, Vince, this probably wasn't going to be a bad... This is probably going to be a bad idea. By the time I hit about a buck 50 and certainly 200, I'm like, my heart's coming out of my chest. I'm sweating my fucking ass off. My legs were killing me. I started thinking to myself, Vince... This was a bad idea. And then, like, by the time I hit 100, I stopped. There's, like, a flat flat, kind of like maybe like a 3 foot walkway that was just like a big flat step you could like stop and rest. So that was like 150, I think 200 was another one. So you just stop there, catch your breath and wait. And then like after that, I stopped every 25 steps at 225, 250, 275, and all the way to the top, man. They don't have, hell that thing, this thing was built in 1800. That thing was built, they built all this in 1800, like carved it out of stone. It's phenomenal, the shit they could do back then. I'd hate to build this goddamn thing, Jesus. But anyway, so literally by the time I got to the top, like the whole time, by the time I got to 200, I'm thinking to myself, I'm going to have a fucking heart attack and die up this goddamn thing because nobody is going to be able to get me. I mean, they might like roll me down the steps or something. There ain't no way in hell ambulance crew is going to go out. All I could think about was getting to the top and having a fucking heart attack and dying up there. Because, I mean, I was telling you, man, it was ridiculous. I was so out of breath. Everybody up there, there was like 10 people up there when I got up there. All of them were like, oh my God. Yo, that thing was fucking terrible going up there. They were like anywhere from kids to... there was a guy older than me. He sat there for a while to get his breath before he came back down. Every once in a while, there are little slits in the stone when you could look out and see Boston. This is the very top grate. That's the very, very bottom. Glad you live. Me too. I was worried I was going to die that bitch. I thought it was going to be Vincent Vega. Here lies the final space of Vincent Vega or whatever. So if you look down that shaft, this is how tall you were up there. That's the very bottom of it. Then up there you got, I didn't notice all this money over here. I don't know how all that money got on that side. This is like, I took a photo from every single angle. There's like, you know, on four sides, there's one different window for each side. You can check it out. Does at least have a slide down? Hell no. That's that big bridge. This is downtown Boston. That's that. Now it's kind of like a world famous bridge. It's kind of like an engineering marvel or whatever when they built the big dig. It's part of the interstate now. That's like another side of Boston. This is the actual. You can see the airport is right there. The big Logan airport for Boston is right there. There's the harbor. This is part of Harvard University. So yes, I called that thing like the staircase of death. Because I'm telling you, my legs, like, I can, like, watch me get out of this chair. Like, I gotta, like, literally, like, like, I'm hurting. Just getting in and out of this chair is fucking killing me, man. Because that wore my ass out. That is the hardest stair climb I've ever done in my entire life, man. It's ridiculous. Going down was no problem, man. Like, my legs were killing me. By the time I got, I mean, I sat outside, took my sweatshirt off, took my hat off, sweat my balls off. You went to Harvard. Yeah, right. Harvard is really weird, man. I thought Harvard would be like a typical college campus. It's nothing like that. It's like a fucking city. And we took a bus tour. This building right here, what's it look like? A big ass church, man. What a view. It's awesome, man. It was really cool. It was worth going up there. Like, here's the story. When I came back down, the park rangers were sitting there. It was like a real old guy and a young dude. And I was wore the fuck out. I went up to that old guy and said, you know what? I can literally tell you this. This is a once-in-a-lifetime experience for me because I'm never going to that motherfucking tower again, ever. One and done. That's it. I'm outie. And now I'm taking a picture. I'm done. Man, this looks like a church, right? But this is Harvard University. This is the freshman, where the freshmen eat. It's like the cafeteria for the freshmen, but it looks like a goddamn, I'm inside of a bus with these plastic walls, so you can't see it that well. That's where the freshmen eat, and these are just random buildings of Harvard. Harvard is 400 fucking buildings, an estimated value of $40 billion. That's what Harvard is worth, realty space-wise, $40 million. It's ridiculous. This is like a square inside of Harvard. I can't remember what that building was. You can see I'm inside this bus. The bus don't really stop. This is actually, you know when they talk about, oh, this is Harvard Square. It's like a little shop. This looks like a regular square at a shopping joint or something. But this is actually Harvard Square. I thought it was kind of weird to see Harvard like this. MIT is in Boston too. That was just a bunch of fucking big buildings. It doesn't look like it. This is like, you can't see the magician. There's a magic show going on right here on the side street next to where we're at. This is like one of the famous, this little building with the little face on it is one of the most famous architectural buildings of Harvard. It's ridiculous. I forgot the guy. The guy who did this was kind of crazy, who designed it. But, you know, you see the eyeballs in the mouth. You know, I took pictures of that. This is that Church of Scientology I told you about. I couldn't get over the fact that this church is, it had to cost $10 or $20 million just to build this church. It's ridiculous. So on yesterday before I got onto the subway, I came back to this church just to take photos of it. The First Church of Christ Scientists. Tom Cruise has been there. This is the front of the damn church. This is all stone, man. It is ridiculous out with the church. That's the beginning of it. And then to the left of it was the Christian Science Publishing Society, founded by Mary Baker Eddy. I have no idea what any of this shit means. I just thought it was crazy. Is Yale better than Harvard? You have some... I was fascinated with this Scientology shit. Because if you go on the interweb, right, and you go look up Boston Scientific Church or whatever, it does not... it just shows you a generic, like... thing about the church. It never shows you images of how beautiful the church is or anything like that. It's big money, man. Big money. Has a trust fund they can't touch for 140 years. Really? Nice. And then, alright, so that was the end of the church. Let's look at the church. Okay, let me give you hashtag story time. So, I took the Amtrak train to go up there and come back. Going up there was hell. Because sitting 8 hours in this fucking Amtrak train was pretty miserable. But once we finally, plus we were like about a half hour delay going up there. So we finally got off, no big deal. Going back wasn't that bad. I was like, you know what? Shit, I'm going to get me some sleepy pills. I'm going to take some sleepy pills. My ass will be asleep by the time I get on the train. When I get on the train at 9:30, I took the sleeping pills at 9 o'clock. Yo, I didn't fall asleep about 1:30. About 1:30, and then about 2:30, you get into Penn Station, New York City. Well, that's the big hubbub where everyone leaves the train and everyone comes back.
Look how big boy.
So there's a ton of people coming back on the train at 4:30, or at 2:30 in the morning. Once you finally leave New York, I finally fell asleep maybe like every 45, I slept for like 45 minutes, wake up for 15, slept for 45, wake up for 15. And finally at 8 o'clock in the morning, wait a minute, 6:30 in the morning, we get back to Baltimore, BWI International Airport. This is what the fuck I find, a flat tire. So after my 8 hours of barely any sleeping, I had to change my goddamn tire in the parking lot. And there's Dookie. And that's it. That's all. I still have a ton of stories to tell. Like, I probably won't remember any of them. I got a lot of paperwork of, like, video games, like, business cards, and all kinds of crazy shit they were giving out. These are, like, pins are really, really big. There's round pins you put on your, like, stuff to show off. That's a really, really big thing. It was pretty cool. I don't know if anybody had any questions or anything. You know, just hit me up. But I had a really great time. It was fucking awesome. Let me let the dog out real quick. Dog gotta go out. So let's go ahead and summarize this whole experience. We had another man down. I got the game besieged. Thanks, NightCal. Appreciate that, man. Let them pictures. You got some good ones. There's some good ones, Luna. I should have taken a lot more. I tell you what. Next year when I've already paid for my airplane tickets. Everything's set up to go to TwitchCon. I'm going to TwitchCon. I'm gonna actually have a professional camera. I'm gonna buy a camera or a lot. Now to stop seeming like I'm sucking you off, you deserve it. It was really fun, man. Like, it was a very cool experience. Let's see. I can't get over these Scientology churches. They're fucking ridiculous. But, like, if I ever went to PAX again, I would do it Friday. Saturday, like, the line for Friday was so fucking ridiculous. An hour and 45 minutes to get into the place. Saturday, I didn't show up till noon, walked up to the front door, got in, no problem. I was done at 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, I was done. Then we had to go out to dinner and do all that kind of extracurricular activities at nighttime, which I didn't do a whole lot anyway. But I met a lot of cool people. I saw all the big-time streamers that were there. That was really cool. I didn't meet any of them except Bacon Donut. I met him. I could have met Dan's Gaming, Waffle7us. They're all at the Nerd Fusion booth. Like, if you went over to the Nerd Fusion booth, like, all the big streamers eventually made their way over there, signing autographs, taking selfies with everybody, but I'm not into all that shit. I'm not really into like a lot of photo opportunities and all that good stuff. At 9 months, Vince would be flooded with paternity tests, and no doubt, no. What was the craziest thing that happened to PAX? You know what? I do have one really weird story. So, like, Boston's got a really weird, you went to PAX, got you. I saw Sean Z. He was in line to meet Lyric. So the line was kind of long. I didn't get a chance to talk to him, but that's the only I saw Sean Z and his girlfriend. They didn't see me because I was kind of like way back, and it was fucking packed. And I was like, you know what? I'm sure I'll catch up with him later. That was Friday, first thing Friday morning, Miller, like 10 o'clock in the morning, or when I got into the door about noon, 12:30, something like that. I never saw Sean Z again for the entire show. I was keeping my eye out for him. I met Severin and Wonks. I met them there. I met a couple streamers I've never seen before, quite a few streamers I've never met before, so hopefully I'll see them on my channel and so forth and all that. I'm trying to think. Oh yeah, there's this homeless dude inside like the steps in the subway. So like I'm going somewhere, I don't know if I was going like two packs or what, coming back. So he was like, this is where his little camp was. He's all camped up in the corners, shit everywhere. And so he was in bad shape. He had a cane and everything. He looked like hell. So like I saw him one day. I came back about 3 hours later and I see him again. This motherfucker is sporting like a brand new Samsung Note, like one of them big tablets, like a big sitting there. I don't know if they have like some kind of homeless interweb app for the homeless or something, but this dude was like going crazy. I said, how the fuck does this homeless guy have a nicer smartphone than most people have? I couldn't get over it, man. I didn't see a lot of homeless people though. And I saw a few, but it was nowhere near like New York City. New York City, man, was homeless everywhere. Boston wasn't like that at all. I would like literally go back to Boston just to vacation there, because that place is awesome. Like, I didn't see anything, but I just kind of like, you know, I said, yo, what is there things to do down here? Like, well, you can go to the aquarium. Bam. That's what I did Sunday morning. It was pretty cool, man. Just hire me to take your pictures next time you go. Yo, I'm going to buy a really nice camera for TwitchCon. I don't think I want to do camcorder stuff. I'm kind of shaky. So I'm going to buy a camera, probably a really nice one before I go. Actually, a couple months before I go get used to it. Maybe you can help me out pick a camera, Mr. Frodo, man, because I have no idea what to get. All right, guys, that's it. If anyone had any questions, man, I had a really good time. PAX was awesome. Like, Friday was phenomenal. When I first, like, when I was back, I got back to my hotel probably like at 8 o'clock at night on Friday, and I just fell out. I was just so fucking tired from doing anything. And I just talked in Discord. A lot of people came into Discord and talked to me because of Drunk Tofu. I talked to people in Discord on Friday night, and Saturday night we went out and, I really didn't go to any like really nice restaurants or anything like that. I'm trying to think what else we did. It was a lot of fun. Like, I would highly suggest, if you're a video game fan, get your ass to a PAX. You don't have to do all 3 days. I'll never do 3 days again.